you've talked about is you want to show people that you can make a comeback and make a spectacular type of comeback. Generally, different things happen to people, a seminal moment in their life where they have to make a change. I know it's happened to me. What was that seminal moment that happened to you last year where you said, you know what, enough of what I've been doing, it's time to make a change?
I went through a lot of things, honestly, the way I live my life, man. You know, I went through a lot. And, you know, one day I just woke up and I said, I'm done. You know, I got to get my shit together. And in order to change, you got to make change, you know, or you instead of get caught up doing the same thing. So, you know, I cut a lot of stuff off. I stopped doing a lot of stuff and, you know, I got myself together. And it was a long road to get to where I'm at today, and I'm here.
Mm-hmm. What's the message you send it to the 140-pound division on Saturday night?
Man, listen. If y'all got a belt, man, just hold on to it. You know, I know y'all get one forever, but, you know, the ones that's coming to me, that shit gonna be mine, man. I'm coming to sweep it all up, man. WBA, WBO, WBC, you know, IBF. So I'm coming to get them all.
Javon, final statement here before we take question from the press. Give us your final statement on what we should expect Saturday night.
No, este sábado se van a esperar una guerra de ambos. Yo vengo a hacer mi trabajo y a buscar esa victoria para Puerto Rico.
This Saturday night, it's going to be a war. It's going to be a war and it's going to be a victory for Puerto Rico.
Adrien, before we take questions from members of the press, give us a final thought. I mean, so many people have written, can't even make 140. Will he be a change fighter? Will he throw more punches? What should we expect Saturday night?
Hey man, you know, just expect a hell of a show. You know, I know he coming to fight. He from Puerto Rico. Puerto Ricans, they come to fight. Mexicans, Puerto Ricans, they all come to fight. So I know he coming to fight, but I ain't just do all this training to go in the ring and not fight. So he gotta know he's to come to a war, he's gonna be in a war too. So, you know, he gotta know that. He better be coming with a lot of equipment, because I got a lot of equipment coming with me, man. So you know, I'm just ready to put it all on the line. Like, I don't know how he feel though, but like, I'm willing to die. I'm willing to put my life on the line. Like, I'm willing to like give it all. Like, I ain't got shit left. I'm willing to do that. I don't know how far he's willing to go. He might start thinking of his kids, grandkids, aunts, nieces, I don't know. But I'm willing to say fuck everything. I'm willing to put it all on the line. I'm ready.
I love that one thing you told
me. Because I'm being listo para morir.
He's ready.
La raya, como dicen en Puerto Rico.
He's ready to die in the line like we said in Puerto Rico.
I love that.
Que le gusta.
I love that.
I think we got to fight. I think we got to fight. Greg Domino from Showtime is going to acknowledge the members of the media who have questions. Greg, let's take our first question.
Excellent. Thank you, Brian. Our first question is from Jeremy Herges of FanSided. The floor is yours, Jeremy.
Hi, Adrien. Hi, John. Thank you for your time. This question is for Adrien. Adrien, I know during the opening comments you used the word retirement at one point. What had you thinking of retirement? Was there a specific reason? If you can talk about your thought process for that, did you really mean it?
I don't know how long you've worked without taking a break, but for me it was like from six years old to what, 30. I never took a break from boxing, and I was just like, you know what? Let me just take a break. I need to take a break. So, you know, that's what I did, and now I'm missing boxing again, and I'm back in it, and we back to it, and we back to it on Saturday night.
Final question for me, for Adrien. As far as getting back into it, I know you talked about, I think you said you had almost 35 pounds to get to where you are now. How hard was that for you, and did you Did you question yourself at times?
Nah. I've been doing this all my life, man. And you know, from the first day, once I woke up, I told GT, like, man, let's go do it. I just been at it, you know. I knew it was gonna hurt. I knew I wasn't gonna like what I was putting myself through, but I knew it all pay off, and you know, I'm here today, and I'm ready to work.
Thank you, Adrien, and best of luck to both of you.
The next question is from Fago Franklin. Please unmute, and the floor is yours.
Hey, how you doing, Adrien? This question is for you. What did you learn about yourself having to overcome obstacles that happened in your life?
I learned that I could stop having sex, man. You know, that was that's one of my biggest problems. You know, I like to party. You know, I like fucking. So I had to cut it all out, the party and the drinking, and, you know, and just get serious with my career and, you know, become that elite fighter and take back over the sport.
Thank you. Thank you, Fago. Just a reminder, if you have questions for Adrien or Giovanni, please raise your hand within the webinar and I will call on you. Once called upon, just unmute yourself. Your next question comes from James Conlon.
Hi, Adrien. Just in terms of that rate, in terms of 2 years, has this been probably one of the most grueling training camps you've ever been on, and have you enjoyed that sort of effect? And in terms of doing your homework, Giovanni, what do you know about it?
You gave me like three questions at one, but I'll answer them. Yeah, it's been a hell of a training camp. Maybe one of the toughest, because I had to get back in rhythm. I had to get my rhythm back, and you know, coming back, losing all that weight, and then working as hard as I do. You know, of course it was tough, and then you know, I didn't want an easy fight, so I picked a guy like Giovanni, because I knew he's gonna push me and bring the best out of me. So you know. That's what I know about him. I know he's a good fighter, he's an undefeated fighter, and he's not here to lose.
And lastly for me, just in terms of Giovanni, this is probably the biggest deal that you've fought so far in your career, and in terms of doing your homework on Adrien, have you watched some of these fights back to pick out some of these key strengths or weaknesses?
No, sí, sé que es la pelea más grande de mi carrera y esta pelea pues no la puedo desaprovechar, tengo que dar el máximo ese día y así va a ser, dar una gran pelea.
Yeah, I know this is the biggest fight of my career. He is a big name, and I'm going to come with everything Saturday night, and I'm going to try to win for Puerto Rico, like I said.
Best local guys.
This could have been one of the biggest boxers in the world. You know, I watched him since I was a kid, and you know, he's been there, he's been on the side of me, and you know, him and Coach Mike, you know, they know what to do to bring the best out of me. So Saturday night's gonna be a hell of a performance.
A question for you,
Duane.
How do you process the talk of Broner getting his life together and a new him on Saturday night? Is it your job to prove him wrong?
Sí, ese es mi trabajo. Este sábado demostrarle a Broner que va a tener que pelear, que espero que venga, como él dice, preparado, porque ese es su regreso y yo no tengo nada que perder, él sí.
I don't have nothing to lose. Adrien Broner has all the everything to lose on Saturday night, so he better bring his A game against me.
All right, thanks for your time. Best of luck to y'all Saturday.
Thank you, RL. Next up, reporting Elie Seckbach.
Hey, Adrien, how's it going? What's up, Brian?
Reporting.
I hear him.
Hey, so, Adrien, you finish over the box again. What do you call you? Say, fresh, fly, and what is it?
Flashy.
How is it going to be for you to walk into a stadium that's going to be empty when you're the one that brings out the crowd that draws all that attention?
Man, you know me, man. I don't give a fuck where I'm at. You can put me in the bathroom and put on the show. So, you know, of course I always want fans there, but, you know, without the fans, that means it's going to be more viewership. So, you know, I'm expecting the numbers to be good, and as, you know, everybody can't wait till I fight. So, you know, Saturday night, you know, the numbers are going to be good, and I'm going to put on a great performance.
One more question, Adrien. You have a lot of celebrity friends. Who's some of the people that are
going
to be up there
and
excited to see you get back in the ring?
Oh, man, a lot of people, man. I don't want to just throw names out there, but you know, they all just happy for me, you know, more so that I really changed and you know, got my life together, and I'm back in the ring. So, you know, everybody's just happy to see me do what I do.
Thank you.
Next question will come from Kenyon Atchison.
Hey, how you doing today, Adrien?
What's up with it?
Hey, I got a question for you. Are you going in looking for the knockout, or being that you haven't fought in a couple years, are you anticipating on just getting a few rounds in?
I'm not looking for, hey, listen, man. I know a lot of people like, man, they don't know this guy, but, you know, these guys like a Giovanni, can be very dangerous because a lot of people don't know him. I know that he's a good opponent. He's coming to fight. He's undefeated. So, you know, I got to stay on my A game. You know, I'm going in to get the victory. You know, whatever presents itself. If a knockout presents itself, I'm taking it. You know, you don't get paid for overtime in this game, and that's just what it is. But I'm definitely coming to get my win.
Okay. And for Giovanni, what exactly is it that you expect to see out of Adrien come Saturday?
No, yo espero que él va a venir a hacer una gran pelea como siempre, porque como todos sabemos, Broner siempre da unos buenos espectáculos y nada, vengo preparado para lo que él venga y veremos a ver qué pasa este sábado.
If he always puts in a show, so Saturday he has to be ready to put his own show against AB.
All right,
thank you. So we'll take our last question now from Joe Sewell.
Thank you very much. You know, before we wrap this up, one thing I thought you said that was interesting, Adrien, is that you talked about coming back and taking over the sport again. And when we talk on the podcast, you know, you make the point that people need to realize I'm still only 30, 31 years old. I'm still young. In this comeback, is it conceivable that Adrien Broner could become one of the pound-for-pound best like he was in his prime, supposedly prime, heyday when you're winning title after title? Is that possible?
Of course, man. You know, everything happened for a reason, and I think this is going to be a great start. And, you know, like I said before, I didn't want no easy way out. So I could have came in and took a bum and took somebody that was just a pushover, a lookover, but I'm not doing that. I love competition. So, you know, I want somebody that's gonna come test me and bring the best out of me. And, you know, that's why I picked Giovanni, and Saturday night is gonna be a hell of a fight.
9 p.m. Eastern, it comes your way. The main event, Adrien the Problem Broner taking on Giovanni Santiago, unbeaten out of Puerto Rico. Gentlemen, let's have a quick face-off. Please make sure you stand. And then we'll go to the co-main fighters next.
Can you move the chair, Brian's chair?
Does AB need to wear a mask?
Agent, you put your mask on.
Someone at
Mays.
He's not doing it.
Where's Mays?
Thank you. Ain't doing much. Take a step back. Cause it's Elie.